Hey yo wagwan guys, and welcome to another video. I know what you're thinking. Why aren't you using your real voice? Well, it's not because many people hate it, or because I'm changing back to the text-to-speech voice, but it's because I really cannot be asked to go back into my shed and set my microphone up. Yes, I record my videos in a shed. So I made a series a while ago on YouTube of my wishlist of cars I wanted to be added back into Horizon 3. It was the series which blew my channel up, and got me to 1000 subscribers in the space of around 4 days. So I'm resuming the series, but as Forza is a bit dead right now, here's a wishlist for Need for Speed Payback. And yes guys, I have Payback now. So enjoy the video, and comment down below any other cars you'd want to see in Payback. Number 1 is the Tesla Model S. The reason I didn't choose the first gen Roadster is because it's too similar to the Lotus Exige. The Model X is too heavy, the Model 3 is too boring, and the new Roadster would be hard to get a hold of and to laser scan it. Apart from that, the Model S could come with decent body kits and customization. For example, the Will.i.am Model S in Los Angeles. It would also be pretty cool to have another car with one gear other than the Koenigsegg Regera. We also don't have any electric cars in Need for Speed, so a Model S would fit in perfectly. And how could we miss the Tesla's signature feature, ludicrous mode?
Stationary on a very straight road.
Oh! Oh! I can't do it. Oh! F- oh! Oh! Oh, I'm feeling dizzy! Why can't I be sick?
Number 2. The Nissan Silvia S14. I don't understand why so many games don't have the S14. Forza players had to beg since Motorsport 4 to eventually get the car in Horizon 3. And most other games don't have the S14, despite having the S13 and the S15. The S14 is an extremely popular drift car, and I believe it's one of the UK's most common drift cars, as I've seen so many in the UK. I don't mind whether they add the Cookie or the Zenki S14, as long as there's a Silvia from this generation. I'm sure everyone else would be happy. Plus, I'm pretty sure everybody can agree that the S14 is one amazing looking car. Number 3, the Bugatti Chiron. We have other hypercars like the Aston Martin Vulcan, the McLaren P1 and the Porsche 918, so where's the king of all hypercars? I'm surprised they haven't added the Bugatti already despite this vast array of supercars and hypercars. Sure, getting a Bugatti Chiron to laser scan would be quite out of effort and time, but just imagine driving down the streets of Fortune Valley in your 1500 brake horsepower Bugatti Chiron, with a wide body, bags, VOS and rims. It'll be so amazing. Then racing it against a Regera would be so much fun. Number 4, the 2011 Audi RS3 Sportback. You may be asking, why not the newer model, or even the older one? Well, I prefer the 2011 version, as I prefer the simple lines and sleek subtle look, almost like a sleeper. Little did they know the car's packing a 2.5-liter TFSI engine pushing out 335 brake horsepower, which is insane for a hot hatch. And fun fact, this is my favorite hot hatchback, even over cars like the M140i, which is strange, because I'm a BMW guy. So why is it my favorite hot hatch? Well, just watch this. Number 5, the Nissan 370Z. Now I know all of you are shouting at your screens, saying that we already have a 350, and we don't need another fair lady, but come on, the 370 is so pretty with those sexy curves and round body. There are no straight lines on the car. It's got the body of an angel with the heart of a devil, a wolf in sheep's clothing. 3.7 liter V6, feeding 320 horses to the rear wheels. This car is the king of oversteering, and rules the hairpins in the mountain roads. It's one of the best drift cars you could buy. And who doesn't love the sound of a little V6?